Changes are being made at polling places and election facilities all across the country, all to enhance security. Now, right now, we're in Baltimore County, Maryland, where they opened this brand new facility just last year with security in mind. And when we talk about security, we're talking about securing the poll workers, the voters, and the ballots themselves.
I've always been interested in voting.
Wanting to make some extra money one summer, Roy Lavoie started working elections and found her passion.
Voting is everybody's fundamental right.
But that fundamental right is sometimes threatened.
A voter voted, and on the way out of the polling place, they made a threat that someone was going to come back and cause harm to those that were there voting and working at the polling place.
Election officials and their staffs are experiencing threats nationwide.
I wish I could say this is the first time I've ever received a death threat.
Threats happening by mail, over the phone.
He will demand the truth and you will pay.
And even in person.
Drop the knife. Back away.
Disrupting voters and the voting process. In fact, a new report from the Brennan Center for Justice found more than 1 in 3 election officials have experienced threats, harassment, or abuse, not just on election day, but before and after the votes are counted.
These are election officials of both parties, threats to them and their families, largely stemming from unfounded claims that the results of the 2020 election did not represent the will of the people.
Jen Easterly is the director of CISA, the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency. They're tasked with creating plans to protect the election process.
We've been doing de-escalation training in case there's some tension that happens around election polling places. We've been doing active shooter training.
In some locations, ensuring security has meant building new voting and election facilities. And that brings us back to Rui. Her passion for the election process that started 14 years ago has now turned into something more.
I am the Director of Elections for Baltimore County, Maryland.
And as the director, Rui helped design a new Board of Elections office. The innovative 45,000 square foot facility is one of several across the country, serving as a blueprint for election security.
So this is the entrance foyer to the Board of Elections office.
We came here for a behind-the-scenes tour.
There's an alarm.
To see the new safety precautions in place for this election and the future.
The glass in this room is all bulletproof type glass.
Yeah, it's all shatterproof.
Life-saving measures for workers, but also ways to secure your ballots if a threat materializes. Because once they start counting your ballots, the process can't be stopped. We were escorted behind multiple doors with restricted access.
This room is only accessible to 2 people.
Taken to rooms where software systems track statistics used for reporting on election night. We also witnessed a pivotal part of the election process the public doesn't often see. The delivery of completed ballots, in this case from early voting. A highly secure and organized operation carried out by a bipartisan team.
Tamper tape is 7.
Involving integrity checks, sign-offs, and a strict chain of custody. Similar steps are taken in every state. And just like in Baltimore County, other places are adding and improving security for staff and voters.
We are planning on there being a lot of attention and people coming to watch what the election workers are doing. So everyone's going to enter this way. And we're going to turn our screening equipment around.
Aaron Dobson from the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office is overseeing security for the courthouse where votes are tabulated.
We're considering all the possibilities of what could happen, and we're hopeful that it doesn't, and that's why we're making plans now to ensure that it doesn't.
All of it being organized by people like Rui, who are passionate about the voting process.
What happens when this system is not safe?
The citizens' votes won't count, and that would be catastrophic. And I don't think we need to worry about that. There are so many behind the scenes being proactive, not just in my local jurisdiction, but across the country.
And all of these security enhancements are for another big reason as well, transparency. Now here in Baltimore County, we've been told that people can come in and watch the election process in person. Other officials across the country have told us if you want to do that, you should reach out to your local election official and set up a time to do so. Reporting in Baltimore County, Maryland, I'm National Investigative Correspondent John Cardinelli.